In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Algebra 2 free worksheet, Graphing Linear Inequalities. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Let's get started with number 1. Number 1 says y is greater than or equal to negative 2x minus 2. Remembering how to graph a linear equation is similar to graphing an inequality, except we're going to be shading in a certain region. So think of this as y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope of negative 2, and b is the y-intercept of negative 2. So I'm going to start by graphing my y-intercept. When x is 0, y is negative 2. And my slope is negative 2, which we could write as negative 2 over 1. So I'm going to go down 2 and 1 to the right, and then plot that new point, 1, negative 4. Since this is a greater than or equal to, that means that y does indeed equal negative 2x minus 2. So when we draw our line, it is going to be a solid line. However, we're still not done. We need to figure out which side of the line are we going to shade. In order to do that, we're going to pick a test point. I like to use the test point 0, 0 when possible. So for picking a test point, I'm going to rewrite our inequality, y is greater than or equal to negative 2x minus 2. I'm going to plug in 0 for y, and I'm going to plug in 0 for x, and see if this inequality is true. If it's true, I'm going to shade in the side that contains 0. If it's not true, I'm going to shade in the side that does not contain the point 0, 0. So let's solve and see. We'll have 0 is greater than or equal to negative 2 times 0, which is 0, minus 2. So we have that 0 is greater than or equal to negative 2, and that is indeed true. So I'm going to shade in the side that contains my point 0, 0. And that's my answer for number 1. So let's quickly go over the steps. We're going to graph our line. It's going to be a solid line if it's greater than or equal to or less than or equal to, and it's going to be a dashed line or dotted line if it's only greater than or less than. Once we decide whether we're going to have a solid or dashed line, we will then shade in one side of that line by picking a test point and then shading the appropriate region. So let's continue on with number 2. In number 2, my slope m is negative 1/3, and my y-intercept b is a positive 1. So I'm going to graph 0, 1, and then I'm going to go down 1 and over 3. So I'll be at 0.3, 0. Now this is a less than or equal to, so y can equal negative 1/3 x plus 1, so this is going to be a solid line. And now let's pick a test point. Let's pick 0, 0. We're going to plug in 0 for y and 0 for x and see if that is true. So y is less than or equal to negative 1/3 x plus 1, plugging 0 in for y and plugging 0 in for x. Is this true? If it is, we're going to shade in the region that includes 0, 0. If it's not, we're going to shade in the opposite region. We'll have 0 is less than or equal to negative 1/3 times 0, which is 0 plus 1. 0 is indeed less than or equal to 1, so we're going to shade in the region that contains 0, 0. And that's our solution in number 2. In number 3, we have x is greater than or equal to negative 2. So treating this like a linear equation, we would graph x equals negative 2, which would be a vertical line, since regardless of the y values, x will always be negative 2. And since x is greater than or equal to, that means that this is going to be a solid line. Now we just have to decide what region are we going to shade. Let's pick a test point. Let's use the point, again, 0, 0, which is this point here. X is greater than or equal to negative 2. We're plugging 0 in for x, and 0 is indeed greater than or equal to negative 2, so we're going to shade in the region that contains the point 0, 0. And that's our solution in number 3. In number 4, our slope m is 1, since 1 times x is equal to x, and our y-intercept b is negative 2. 2, since subtracting a positive is the same as adding a negative. So plotting 0, negative 2, and then the slope is 1, which we could write as 1 over 1. So we'll go up 1 and to the right 1. Now we'll draw a line. However, notice this is not less than or equal to, it is less than. So that means that our line is going to be a dashed line. So now that we've drawn our dashed line, we have to decide which region to shade. So let's plug in our test point 0, 0. And we can use that test point because it does not fall on the line. If 0, 0 was to fall on the line, we would have to choose a different test point. So just to show you, let's choose negative 1, 1. So we're going to plug negative 1 in for x and 1 in for y. So y is less than x minus 2. We're going to plug in the point negative 1, 1. So 1 gets plugged in for y and negative 1 gets plugged in for x. And we have to see, is this inequality true? If it is, we'll shade in the region that contains point negative 1, 1. If not, we'll shade in the opposite region. So we get that 1 is less than negative 1 minus 2, which is negative 3. 1 is not less than negative 3, therefore 1 negative 1 is not in the shaded region, so we will shade in the opposite region. And that's our answer in number 4. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, and while you're clicking that subscribe button, go ahead and click the thumbs up for this video. If you have any questions, leave a comment below, and continue on to the next video where I'll complete problem numbers 5 through 8.